Do you have diabetes? Uncontrolled diabetes can lead to many serious consequences, including heart disease, kidney disease, blindness, and other complications. Prediabetes has also been linked to this condition. So in this video, we are going to show you foods to avoid if you have diabetes and prediabetes. People with diabetes that consume too many carbohydrates at one time, which are broken down into sugar, can cause dangerous spikes or rises in blood sugar levels. It is important to avoid the following when it's possible. 1. Sugar-sweetened beverages, like 354 milliliters can of soda, provide 38 grams of sugar, the same as sweetened iced tea and lemonade each contain 36 grams of carbs exclusively from sugar. They are loaded with fructose as well, strongly linked to insulin resistance and diabetes. Studies suggest that sugar-sweetened beverages may increase the risk of diabetes related to condition like fatty liver. Instead of sugary drinks, drink water or club soda to help control blood sugar level and prevent the risk of disease. 2. Fruit juice is not really a healthy beverage, nor is a suitable alternative for other sugar-sweetened beverages. This is because the fruit sugar is concentrated when juiced, so you end up drinking a lot more fruit than you could ever possibly eat. 250 milliliters or 8 ounces of unsweetened apple juice contains 24 grams of sugar, which is the same as a soda. Fruit should really be consumed in its whole form, where it still contains fiber and the amount of sugar is much lower. A much better alternative to juice: water with a wedge of lemon, which is a calorie-free. 3. Dried fruit. Fruit has a lot of great vitamins. It is a great source of nutrients, but when fruit is dried out, the sugar content becomes much more concentrated, much like juices. For example, 1 cup of grapes contains 27 grams of carbs, including 1 gram of fiber. By contrast, 1 cup of raisins contains 115 grams of carbs and 5 grams of fiber. That is equivalent to 20 teaspoons of sugar. Dried fruit contains very concentrated amounts of carbs and sugar, so you really have to watch out for your portion sizes. So if you have diabetes, you don't have to give up fruits altogether. Sticking with low sugar fruits like fresh fruit, fresh berries, or small apples can provide health benefits while keeping your blood sugar in the target range. 4. Honey, agave nectar, and maple syrup. Here are the carb counts of 1 tablespoon serving of popular sugar alternatives. White sugar, 12.16 grams, honey, 17 grams, maple syrup, 15 grams, agave nectar, 16 grams. Agave nectar certainly is not a better choice, because it is naturally high in fructose. The best strategy is to avoid added sugar and use low-carb sweetener instead. If you want to add sweeteners to a meal, pay attention to the carbs and choose the right portion for your meal plan. Although natural sweetener may not be processed as the same as sugar, but it has the similar effect in blood sugar. 5. White bread, pasta, and rice. These are high-carb foods. According to study, eating bread and bagels to significantly increase blood sugar levels for people with type 1 and type 2 diabetes. They tend to be high in carbs, low in fiber and protein. All of this will contribute with high blood sugar, since the fiber slows down the conversion of carbs into sugar, and protein helps slow down the spike. Instead, try to enjoy a higher fiber option, such as pasta made from beans or lentils, brown rice, whole grain, or a high-fiber bread. Be mindful of enjoying appropriate portions. If you really enjoy the taste and flavor of white pasta and rice, and balance it off with a high-fiber veggie side dish. Also an adequate lean protein to minimize the impact on your blood sugar. 6. Candy. Obviously, candy. But unless you're sticking to sugar-free gum, almost all candy is full of the sweet stuff. The more sugar you consume in a concentrated amount, the more your blood sugar is affected. 7. Alcohol, drinking booze, can actually cause hypoglycemia, meaning your blood sugar to drop too low, because alcohol interferes with your liver's ability to produce glucose. What's more, alcohol doesn't mix well with certain diabetes medications. It is important that you know your blood sugar before you drink, and avoid drinking on an empty stomach. Because when your blood sugar is already low, and your risk of severely low blood sugar only increases the more you drink. Also, no more than one drink per day for women and two drinks per day for men. People with diabetes should follow the same moderation rules set for everyone else. Although everyone is different, so it's important to talk to your doc about your personal limits. Thank you for watching. Like, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel, especially Wellness.